Welcome to ECE 3300, Introduction to Electromagnetics. In this lecture, we're going to review complex numbers and phasors in terms of how you're going to use them in electromagnetics. You've learned about these concepts before in your math and physics, and what I want to show you is how we use complex numbers to make our math very simple in electromagnetics. So let's first consider phasors. If we have a simple sine wave, perhaps this is a voltage. This is a voltage that is propagating as a function of time. We can write that voltage as an amplitude times the cosine of omega t minus beta z, if it's going in the z direction, plus phi. If it happens to be going in the negative z direction, this would be a positive. So there's our voltage. This is the time domain form of the voltage, because you can see that time is included in the equation. This right here is the angular frequency that's given in radians per second. This is the time given in seconds. This is the propagation constant given in radians per meter. And this is the distance traveled in meters. The phase shift is also given in radians. Now the time domain form is very useful. It's the sort of thing we'd see on an oscilloscope. But most of the time we want to do our math in the frequency domain because it's easier. The frequency domain is also called the phasor domain. And in this domain, it is assumed that we know the frequency. We can say that the frequency is implied. We can rewrite our voltage in terms of phasors, where it is A, and instead of using cosine, we use e to the j. It's going to be e to the j omega t, e to the minus j beta z, and e to the j b. Because this is the frequency domain, this term right here, e to the j omega t, is assumed. It's implied. It's still there, but it doesn't show up in the equation. It's interesting to remember that in electrical engineering, we typically use e to the j omega t, and in physics, they typically use e to the minus j omega t. All that it does is changes the sign of the remaining terms in the complex numbers. So our voltage is A, e to the minus j beta z, e to the j phi. It can also be written as A, e to the j theta, where theta is minus beta z plus phi.